So yoga hit, it's all about that high intensity, but it's also about obviously being really mindful on your own limits. So, there's nothing worse than taking some type of fitness class and afterwards you're like, that was too hard for me. You never should leave a class saying that was too hard because there's always a way for you to modify, especially in this format, okay? So, for example, if you're jumping and you know that you're somebody who's kind of new to working out, or you have knee issues or hip issues, right? Then all you're gonna do is this, right? You can lift one leg at a time. You can march in place. You can just squat and stand, okay? So when you see us doing this, right? That might not be for you. You're just gonna do this, right? And you can do single time as opposed to double. Right? We might go fast, you're just gonna go slower, okay? So I'll be giving all those modifications, but just be really mindful to your own body's energy. Don't look around and see what everyone else is doing and compare yourself to that. You're here, that's like already success, okay? So let's get started. Bring your feet together, bring your hands together. I want you to take a deep breath in. And full breath out. Okay, we're gonna inhale, sweep the arms up overhead, grab hold of the right wrist and lean to the left. Come back up through center, inhale, grab the left and lean to the right. Inhale, come back through center, clasp your hands and then press your palms forward, relax the head. Inhale, lift all the way back up. Exhale, round the spine, we'll go sideways. One more time, inhale up, grab hold of the right wrist, knee to the left. Come back through center, inhale, grab left and lean to the right. Inhale, come back through center, clasp your hands behind your back and fold over the legs. Good. We're going to start with our first one. It's going to be a step out and step in. We're going to work for 40 seconds and then hop off for 15 seconds. Okay? So we're gonna come to stance. We're gonna just start stepping out and in, out and in. So now here's where you can make it more effort, less effort, okay? Less effort, hands into your hips. The move is smaller, okay? More effort, step out. Really take a big step out. Even more effort, arms reach forward. You want higher effort, arms reach up. Anytime your arms, your hands go above your heart, you're going to increase your heart rate. You have 8 seconds left. Last three. Last two. And one. Come back through center. We're going to lower our arms down. Next move, I'll just show you first. It's going to look like this. So you're standing in Tadasana. Your knee moves up to your elbow. So try to make contact knee to elbow, as opposed to doing this, right? Think of knee up to your elbow. Go ahead, you got 30 seconds. Really nice. Good, everyone. Nice, Phyllis, I am so proud of you, by the way, that you're here. This is amazing. Keep it going. Awesome, make sure you're moving out to the side. You want that lateral movement. You have 10 seconds. 8, 7, 6, 5. We're gonna move into jumping jacks. Keep going. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Come back through center. So we always have about 15 seconds in between. You're gonna jump out, out, in. So it's a yoga jack. Out, out, in. If that's too much, you're gonna just step out and in like this. This is a really great place to sit, or we jump. So it's out, out, in. 30 seconds. I actually like it better without music. I can focus better. Keep going. Nice. You have 10 seconds. And then once we're done, we're going to go back to those step outs. 3, 2, We're going to take just a little break. You can choose how long your break is. I'm giving you 15 seconds, but you can start as soon as I start, okay? So you're going to step out and in. Technically, you still have 3 seconds to your break. That's up to you. Arms reach forward or arms reach up overhead. Now, if you want even more intensity, get low. Get as low as you can and spring up. Because the next one will be, right, a little bit of a hop. All the way down, all the way up. The lower your butt goes, the more intense it'll be. Notice my, like I'm out of breath. That's what you want. You want to feel that breathlessness. Last 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, come back to center. You should start feeling with that sense of cardiovascular. All right, your big toes to touch. Start with your hands behind your head. We're going to move into that lateral movement. So this is for your obliques, right? So not only, it's actually not just your obliques, it's also your hips, right? So squeeze and lower. If you touch your obliques on each side, you should feel the contraction, right? So again, it's all about getting your knee up as high as you can, but meet it with your elbow. If you don't get that side bend, you're not going to feel it in the obliques. So if it's this, then you're just working legs. But if it's this, now you're working obliques. You have to get that crunch. That's what it feels good. You want to squeeze and crunch to each side. Oh, 3, 2, and 1. Okay, we have 10 seconds rest. Hold it here. We're going to move into those jumping jacks. You can start whenever you want. Technically, you have... And go. Out, out. It goes really fast. Out, out, in, out, out, in. I have a Tabata timer, so I can't screw up my timing. Keep going. Last 20 seconds. Last 20 seconds. Make the break a little bit shorter. Good. Last 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Come back through center. Last one. Okay, we're going to step out and in. We still have 5 seconds of rest. 3, 2, and go. All the way. Now, if you want to get even lower, look. Step out almost like you're coming into like that skandhasana, like that side squat. All the way up. All the way up. Remember, arms forward. You're going to work a lot harder. You want your butt all the way back and together. All the way up and together. Denise, I have a feeling you're going to text me later, angry text going, you need to take your own damn class. Keep going. Nice, Margarita. Good. All the way up, all the way in. 2, and 1. Come back through center. We have one more standing twist. Last 3, 2, and start. Elbow to knee, elbow to knee. The faster you move on this round, again, the more intense. You want to feel that crunch. So I want to just show you something. If I do this, do you see that little, I don't know if you could see, see how I'm like dipping to each side? I feel so much, I actually feel like I'm doing crunches on the ground. So it's all about the contraction that you're doing, right? It's not even about the arms. The arms are just kind of like a little guy. Keep squeezing the belly in. Last 4, 3, 2, moving into jumping jacks. Good, we have 8 seconds rest. Last 3, 2, and 1, go right into your jumping jacks, or your yoga jacks, I should say. They're not jumping jacks. Good. Out, out, in, in. Out, out, in, in. Go as slow or as fast as you need to go. You have 20 seconds. Keep it going, keep it going.
Nice, everyone. Last five, four, three. Did I get it to fix? Two. I think I have music. And one. Come back to the center. Do you guys hear music? Yes? Okay. Great, cool. All right, so now we're going to come to the front of our mats. We're going to move right into Surya Namaskar A, and I'll kind of guide you through from there. Inhale, arms reach up. Exhale, fold. So just start a regular vinyasa. Lengthen the spine, inhale. You can either step or jump it back, move through your flow, until we're in downward facing dog. But now, ready? From downward facing dog, you're going to step your right foot forward. Okay, now listen, your hands come to the floor, or if you have blocks, you can put blocks under your hands if you need it. All we're gonna do, ready, is jump to switch. Jump to switch. Jump to switch. So I love using the blocks. It actually really helps me get a little more lift. Jump to switch. If you don't have blocks, make fists with your hands. Put your fists to the floor. Jump to switch. Jump to switch. One more. Jump to switch. Good. Step forward with your back foot. Inhale all the way up. Exhale, hands together, heart center. Good. That's round one. Okay? All right. Moving on. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, fold over the legs. Inhale, lengthen. Step or jump back. Notice I'm just stepping. Lower down into your chaturanga. Upward facing or maybe cobra. Downward facing dog. Good. You can bicycle up the knees a little. Good. Step your right foot forward. Inhale, rise up. You're going to make like cactus arms. Hold it here. And then, ready? Back knee down. Forearms together. Open it up, straighten the leg. Forearms together. And straighten. Forearms together. And straighten. Last five. Four, three, two, and one. Come back up, hold it here. Your arms go all the way up overhead. Now, ready? We're just gonna open up to warrior two, right? So it's the right side, I gotta turn around. So your right arm forward, your left arm back. Good. We're gonna cactus those arms. Ready? Draw in, straighten the front leg. And back. Straighten. Bend. Straighten. Bend. Straighten. Bend. That's it for four, three, two, and one. Open the arms wide. Now listen, we're gonna lower our hands to frame the right foot. Step back to downward facing dog. Now we're gonna come onto all fours. Okay, we're gonna come onto all fours. But I want you to lift your knees just a little bit off the floor. Turn your hands in. So look at where my butt is, right? You don't want your butt all the way forward. You don't want it in downward facing. Your knees are bent, right? Your hands turn in slightly. So it's a push-up. So we're gonna go down and up. Now, if this is too hard for you, please watch me. Drop your knees and do the same thing. It's just down and up, okay? But if you can handle it, keep your knees up. You've got 10 seconds. Just down and up. Eventually, we're gonna start opening up from there and doing some crazy stuff. Last, two, and one. Straighten the legs. Look between the hands. Sweep the arms all the way up. Hands together, heart center. Let's pause here.
I just want to get a check-in. We're good, we're breathing, we're alive. Okay.
Alright. So we're gonna go back to that sun salutation A. Ready? So your feet are together. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, fold over the legs. Inhale, lengthen halfway up. Step or jump back. Upward facing on the inhale. Downward facing on the exhale. Good, step the left foot forward. Remember, if you have blocks, blocks are really, really helpful. Place your hands to the blocks and jump switch. Actually, let mine go a little higher and jump switch. Good, and when you just keep jump switching.
Last 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good. Step forward. Inhale, arms reach up. Hands stay on the heart center. Pause here. Moving on. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, fold over the legs. Inhale, lengthen. Step or jump up. Upward facing inhale. Downward facing exhale. Your left foot comes forward. Inhale, rise up. Hips deep. You're going to cactus out those arms. Draw the forearms together. Down. Knee down. Press up. Arms open wide. Knee down. Forearms together. Inhale, rise back up. Good. So just keep that going. You got 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, and then open up into your warrior two. So this is your rest. And your rest is just holding warrior two. You got like dripping sweat. I'm not even working as hard as you. All right, so sink a little bit deeper. Gaze over that whatever hand, your left hand. Last breath here. Cactus out the arms. Straighten your legs, arms together. Open, close. Open, close. Keep that going. Bending, straightening. I actually really love this action of the bending and the straightening for that inner seam of your leg. Feels so good to me. But last 5, 4, 3, and 1. Hold it here. Lower the hands to frame your left hand. Step back, downward facing dog. Drop onto your knees to start. Hold it here. Spread your fingers wide. Turn your hands in just slightly. We're going to come into spider. Lift your knees a few inches off the floor and press back. Again, you don't want to be forward. You want to push your chest back. And then we're going to go down and up. Now this time you can either stick with the basic, just down and up, or you're going to go down and open up. Down, open up. Okay? So that's entirely up to you. You could also go down and kick that right leg through. Ah, get fancy. Down, left leg under, right? It's like a little bit of that fallen triangle, but your knees are bent once you come back to that spider. Woo! Keep going. Last 3, last 2, and 1. Okay, find downward facing dog. The present has no ribbon. Nice. Gift keeps on giving. Look between the hands, step or jump the feet forward. Inhale, sweep the arms around and up. Hands together, heart center. Good, so we're gonna do one more round with that. All right, anyone's drippy? Where am I sweating? Okay, ready? So, here you have your feet are together. We're gonna move right into that. Surya A again. Inhale, arms reach up. Exhale, fold over the legs. Inhale, lengthen. Step or jump back. Remember, this is our last one. Upward facing, downward facing. Good. Step the right foot forward. Use your blocks if you need them. Jump switch. Okay, 25 seconds, just jump switching. Now, I want you to notice what my hips are doing. See if my hips are like really hopping. If I had a trainer next to me, they'd probably yell at me. So you don't want to do that. I wasn't really paying. It's easy to like get out of bad alignment. So you want to try to keep your hips down to jump switch, right? It's more like this, less of that hopping. So you just want to try not to bounce your hips up and down. All right, pause. Find downward facing dog. Ooh-wee! And then step or jump your feet forward. Inhale, lengthen, exhale, fold. Keep the arms around and up. Inhale. Oh god, hands together, heart center. Exhale. Good. Inhale, arms reach up. Exhale, fold over the legs. Inhale, lengthen, halfway up. Step or jump back. Lower into your chaturanga, maybe cobra. And then find downward facing dog. Remember, If you're at the point where you're like, oh, this is too much, you're too tired, you're doing something wrong, you have to modify. Okay? Step the left foot forward. Inhale, rise all the way up. But cactus the arms and bend into that back knee and squeeze forearms together. Bend and squeeze. Bend and squeeze. Last 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now hold it here. All you need to do is straighten your legs, pivot to the other side so that we're even. Bend. And forearms together. So we want to make sure we get both sides evenly. So my heart. Last 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Straighten the leg. Open up warrior 2. Okay, so now you're on your left side, I believe. I hope so. Do whatever opposite you did before. Good. Hold it here. Cactus out those arms, forearms together, straighten the leg, and open, and straighten. Good, keep that going. Open, nice, and close. So you're just doing with those straight legs. I think I was mirroring you before as well. Good, last 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, straighten the legs, now pivot to the other side, and again, you have the time here. Good, last 3, 2, and 1, lower your hands all the way down. Come onto all fours, turn your hands in slightly. Okay. As the leaves turn brown. Okay, so now we're going to curl our toes under. It's so much for this stuff to do. So turn your hands in slightly, lift your knees, push back. Remember, we're going to do a push-up. Now, the most challenging would be this one. Head down, left leg under, open the right arm up. We do this in class all the time, right? But we don't do it with our knees bent. So again, push-up, right leg under, left arm up. Knees are always bent. Push up. Left. Actually, they're not bent when you straighten your leg under. When you straighten your leg under, it's straight. But otherwise, you keep your knees bent. You have 10 seconds left. How many can you do? Push up and straighten the leg. Push up and straighten. If that's too much, you lower your knees and you find your spider push-ups. Super simple. All right, last 3, 2, 1. Beautiful. Find your way to downward facing dog. Look between the hands. Step or jump the feet forward. And then uncurl the spine all the way up. All right, let's just hold it here. We need water, grab some water. Alright, so we're going to go into our squatting, some fun derriere stuff. Okay, so you're going to bring the feet together, and we're going to find chair pose. And we're going to start in chair pose. Your arms reach forward and up. I like to just sometimes bring my hands to my hips to start, right? Sometimes it just makes it a little easier. And all we're going to do is curtsy back and together. Back and together. Now you can stay super simple, just like this, nice and slow. You can reach your arms forward and up. This is not as easy, right? And then, of course, you can get lower, right? The lower you go, the more you're going to feel it. The more you get your leg to the outside, right? The more sensation you're going to feel. It's all about sensation. And if you're really badass and you want to, you can even keep that foot off the floor that's crossing back. All right, pause. Everyone come to the center. Good. Just pause here. I'm going to actually skip gonna move into a side squat, step out. Okay, so we're gonna step out three times. I hope you can see, I don't know what's easier, if I don't know how face it. Okay, so we're gonna start stepping out to the right. It'll look like this. One, two, three, curtsy. Okay, and again. One, two, three, curtsy. Okay, and again. One, two, three, curtsy. Now ready, we're gonna pulse. One, two, three. Okay, so it's one, two, three. One, two, three. Good. One, two, three. And now we're starting. One, two, three. Keep that going. So it's out three, back three. Woo! All on the left. We've got 30 seconds.
And come
a little power move. So lower your hands to the floor. We're just gonna step back to plank pose. Now watch me first. You have to pull the belly in. We're gonna jump our feet to the outside and reach our arms forward. You lower your hands down, jump back. Jump forward, arms up, and back. Goes like this, and back. Okay, you have 20 seconds. If that doesn't work for you, please watch me. All you have to do is this. Right foot forward, step back. Left foot forward. Right, and left. So that's a great option. Last 7 seconds. Last 3, 2, and time. Good. Hold it here. Hold it here. All right. Where are we? So, for time. Okay, cool. So, we're going to come into a plank series. So, we're going to have a little fun with our plank. All right. So, let's come down onto our, into our plank. Start with your knees. So we are going to do this for time. This is only for time. This is not for not the same kind of Tabata. We're doing just kind of general. So always the rule is if you have to drop down onto your knees, you drop down onto your knees. If you don't have to drop down on your knees, try to keep them up the entire 3 minutes. So we're going to do a 3 minute plank. Okay, we're just going to do all different ways. All right, so let's get started. Onto your forearms. Ready? 3, 2, 1. Okay? So you're in your forearm plank. Now make sure your butt is not lifted. You want your butt in line with those hips. Keep the belly pulling in. Now look, you see how like dancer you're tilting? Like, you see how my butt's lifting? Watch. You want to tuck the tailbone and then lower it down so that you really squeeze the belly. Hold it here, you got 5 more seconds before a change. 3, 2, we're gonna come onto our right side. So the right forearm plank. Oh, this is it. Okay, forearm plank. You have 30 seconds here. So reaching up to that right arm. So the same thing though. Feel the belly pulling in. Think of like, remember like medieval times and the women wore those crazy corsets, right? You wanna imagine this corset around your torso. Sucking you in, right? You want to use those muscles. Hold it here. You got 4, 3, 2, turn to the other side. Okay, left. So now we're in left forearm plank. Don't give up. Remember, if you have to drop a knee and then come back up, it's totally okay. Hold it here. Pushing those hips up. Keep pressing those hips up. Hold it here. Last 3, 2, 1. Okay, come back through center. Now we're gonna come up into plank pose. Okay, so we have 1 minute and 20 seconds left. That's all it is. Okay, so spread your fingers wide. We're in plank, and we're just gonna do a little leg lifts. That's it. Nothing crazy. Just a leg lift. We've been actively working in the class for 32 minutes. To the good old days, when the mama sang. Keep going. Last 3. Oh no, never mind. Sorry, you have 20 seconds. Sorry. Keep going. 10 seconds. But now we're stressed out. And then all we have is 30 seconds left. Okay, ready? You can either stay here in your plank, you can drop back down in your forearm plank, or we're gonna come into some mountain climbers. This is it, 30 seconds. Make a candle out of it if I ever found it. Try to sell it, never sell out of it. I probably only sell 20 seconds. It's my brother, because we have the same nose, same clothes, homegrown, a stone's throw from a creek we used to roam. But it would remind us of when nothing really mattered. Out of student loans and treehouse homes, we all would 10 seconds. My name's blurry face, and I care what you think. Last 4, 3, 2, and 1. Lower it all the way down. Here's my timer. Okay. Lie all the way down. Hopefully you can see me. awesome. Okay. So we're gonna reach our arms all the way forward. Bring your forehead to the floor. And then on your inhale, all we're gonna do is just lift our legs and lift our upper body. Just hold it here. Really just want you to get a good stretch in the front of your belly, back, four, three, two, and one. Lower it all the way down. Turn your head to one side. All right, come back to center. Arms reach forward and legs back. We're going to lift again. Inhale, lift for five, four, three, two, and one. Lower it all the way down. So now we're going to move into this really cool move. It's like a back bending move. So just make sure you have room to the right side of you and to the left side of you. Okay. I'm gonna just turn the music off just so you can hear me okay. Okay, all right. Okay, so this is one of my favorite back stretches that I do, but we're gonna add a little bit more movement to it. So your arms open wide. All right, I hope you can see me. You're gonna turn your head to the left. Bend your left knee, lift your thigh. So you're gonna need to bend your left elbow here so that you can kind of lift your chest and then move your left over to the right. Oh God, I just cracked a lot. And then come back, you center, your lower all the way down and then switch. So if you have bosoms, if you're bosomy like me, you really do have to lift your chest and kind of move them out of the way. So now we're gonna lift, okay? Your right elbow's bent. Oh, right foot over to the left side. Oh, there's another pop. Come back to your center, lower it down. Good, again, bend your left knee. Lift, center all the way over to the right. Center, lower it all the way down. And we're just gonna keep this going. Oh, this is like heaven. I actually find that I have a hard time breathing in this, which tells me something, that I'm really tight in my back. And I probably store a lot of tension and fear, worries in that area. That's what it tells me. Lower it down. Let's do one more round on each side. All right, come back from center, lower it down, and then push yourself up. Good, so we're gonna come to sit. Awesome, we have about 6 more minutes, that's it. All right, so if you have a block, I hope you guys have blocks. So if you have a block, I did this in class last night, it was amazing. I actually woke up, my legs felt sore. So your hands alongside your hips. This is actually just a cool down stretch, but it's such a good stretch. You'll feel it. Okay, so now you're gonna point your right foot. I don't even think you can see what I'm doing. So I'm gonna move this. Sorry. I wanna make sure you can see what I'm doing. Oh, that's better. I'll do it this way. Okay, cool. So you're gonna point. I'm a perfectionist. All right, you're gonna point your right foot, okay? And then all we're gonna do is use our hands to anchor. So here's what I don't want you to look like. We don't wanna be rounded, and we don't wanna be like this. So if you need to sit up against the wall, sit up against the wall, that's perfectly fine. Point your right foot, you're gonna lift your right leg and hover over that block for five, oh my God, four, three, two, one, tap down on the block, and then lift for three, two, one. Tap down and lift for three. You can use anything instead of a block. You can literally use a can, a book, whatever you have in front of you. Tap down and lift. Three, two, one. Tap down and lift. You guys feel that in your quad. Three, two, One, tap down and lift. Three, two, and lower it all the way down. We're gonna switch sides. Point the left foot and lift it up. Hold it here. Keep the chest lifted and hold it. Five, four, three, two, one, tap down and lift. Five, it's really hard to maintain good posture. And tap down and lift. Three, two, wow, one, and lift. I'm sweating so much just doing this. Tap down and lift. Three, two, and one. Oh man. And then lower it down, and we're just gonna fold over the legs. Woo! Holy cow. That's really good for your hip joints, everyone. That wasn't meant to be like a hip move that's supposed to, you know, be like a workout move. It's really a functional move. All right, so we're gonna come back. And we're gonna open our legs really wide. So I've been a nerd for the last 4 months in solitary confinement. And all I do is study with teachers and all these cool physical therapists that I've met. And I've been learning all these functional movements. And it's like literally changed my practice and the way my body moves. And it's really pretty awesome. But these are two that I've been practicing and learning. All right, so the next one is like a little weird, but again, we're gonna work together. So if you need a wall so that, it's so sweaty. If you need a wall, okay, you can sit up against the wall, right? Otherwise you can sit in a room, but you have to maintain that good posture, right? So you're gonna take your hands, bring them one hand to the inside, one hand to the outside. We're gonna point our feet. We're gonna lift, oh my God, lift our right leg, bend the knee, and then lower the foot down, okay? Switch, point the foot, lift, holy cow, bend, and lower your foot down. Go back over to the other side. Lift, straighten, and lower down to the other side. Lift, straighten, and down. Doesn't look hard until you do it, okay? And we're gonna go back over to the other side. Lift, holy cow, bend, and down. So again, your legs are wide to the other side. Lift, bend, and down. Switch, lift, straighten, and down. Other side. Lift, straighten, down. One more. Lift, bend, and lower. Lift, bend, and lower. Nice. And then just bring the soles of the feet together. We're just going to shake it out. Just stretch out those adductors, your inner leg muscles, your abductors, your outer leg muscles. Woo! I hope you guys had fun today. I kind of had fun. I mean, I always have fun, but it's hard teaching and doing it at the same time. All right, bring the feet in a little bit closer. Keep shaking it out. I admire so much all my fitness friends who teach crazy boot camps and all these classes that are like really fast for an hour. And I don't know how they do it. I don't know how they teach and do the class at the same time. Good. And then go ahead and just fold over the legs. Ugh. But then again, they probably look at yoga teachers and they're like, oh, I don't know how they teach that stuff. It's crazy. I guess you get good at what you practice. That probably makes sense. All right. Go ahead and cross your legs. Take a deep breath in. Your arms reach up overhead. Clasp your hands. Press up through your palms. And go ahead and just move a little side to side. And then round the upper back, press the palms forward. Inhale, opening arms wide. Exhale, round. Inhale, open. Exhale, round. And one more time. Inhale. And exhale. And then bring your hands together to your heart. And let's just bow our chin towards earth, through in so much gratitude for our strength, for your discipline to show up, to uncover this stronger, healthier, better version of yourself so that you could bring that into the rest of your life. I thank all of you so much for joining me. May we be healthy, may we be happy, and together may we all find peace. Namaste. So thank you guys so much for joining us. Again, my name is Cindy from the Yoga Shack in Bethpage, New York. We would love for you to join us again. Please, please, please subscribe. The button is below. When you subscribe, it actually really helps small businesses like ourselves to reach a wider audience. So we would really be so grateful. Please check out all of our other videos. We have lots of meditations and do-it-yourself tutorials and just a bunch of fun stuff that we've posted. And you can always reach out to us, theyogashackny.com. All right, hope to see you soon. Peace out.